congratulations, you've made it into the Exponential Growth Workshop. Now, whether you're someone who's actively trying to follow the philosophy of Stoicism, or you're just someone who's using it as a tool to reach their goals quicker, you're in the right place, perhaps the best place on the whole of the internet, but I am a little bit biased. My name's Andrew Kirby. I'm an international speaker, author, and entrepreneur, and I help thousands of people, literally hundreds of thousands of people on my YouTube channel, use Stoicism to become people that they're proud of. This is the first in a series of 3 free training videos where we're going to go over how you can start making tiny changes in your life that bring you remarkable results and let you reach goals bigger than the ones that you're currently setting. Actually reach the goals bigger than the ones you're currently setting whilst still having more free time and more freedom. But I still remember that one time a couple years back when I was lying in bed and I awoke from a deep sleep with a huge jolt. I slid myself off the bed and I stared at myself in the mirror. I was heaving up and down with deep breaths and there was cold sweat dripping off my face. My whole life I had promised myself that I was going to be different. I wasn't going to get stuck in a mind-numbing 9-to-5 job. I wasn't going to chase money with an empty feeling inside of my stomach. I wasn't going to settle for far less than my potential. But that person that I was looking at in the mirror was exactly the person I'd promised myself not to be. I was stuck in a rut. I'd play computer games for 3, 4, 5, and even 6 hours. I ate badly. I never exercised. I never socialized. I was depressed. But despite following this routine, I still thought I was gonna get lucky. I still thought I was gonna be an overnight success like you read on the news. I thought someone that would just gift me success. I was so delusional. At that moment, when I was staring at myself in the mirror, I had the biggest epiphany that I've ever had. And that epiphany was very simple, but remarkably powerful. The epiphany was that there was no such thing as breakthrough moments. I realized that the only thing that matters is the decision that you make now. And 99.999 of times, the decision you make now isn't notable. And often it isn't even noticeable. Let me explain what I mean. Bob and Jim were two men and they both had wanted to be an actor their whole life. And essentially, they were the same people. They had exactly the same upbringing and exactly the same genetics. But for one reason or another, they started making different decisions. When eating at a restaurant, Bob would choose a burger, whilst Jim would choose a salad. When asked by a friend to go to the gym, Bob would say he's busy, whilst Jim would always go. Now, these decisions are decisions that we face often in our life. And because of these two decisions, Jim was more healthy and more energetic. But that's only the first order consequences. Because Jim ate healthily and went to the gym, he was more healthy and more energetic. And because he was more healthy and more energetic, he was able to be, you know, just 5% more productive in the day. And that 5% more productivity allowed him to go to 5% more classes, acting classes, throughout the year. And it also allowed him to start meditating. On top of this, whilst Jim was at the gym, he was getting used to being outside of his comfort zone and striving under pressure. Meanwhile, Bob would just stay at home and he would watch YouTube all day, every day. And one day, they were both asked to an interview for a brand new Hollywood film. They were so excited and they both went in, they both performed their part, and then they walked out. Weeks went by and no news came in, but 3 weeks later, who got the results came in, and Jim had got the job. Bob was disappointed and he would say to himself that, why can't I perform when it really matters? But in reality, that wasn't why Bob didn't get the job. He didn't get the job because of all of his previous decisions, not because of his ability to perform when it matters. And it's kind of like an ice cube. Imagine the ice cube in a room where the temperature is -4 degrees Celsius. And then someone turns up the temperature by 1 degree, minus 3 degrees Celsius, and the ice cube doesn't change. Someone turns up by 1 degree, minus 2 degrees Celsius, no change. Again, minus 1 degree Celsius, no change. Switches up to 0 degrees Celsius, again, no change. But one more switch, up to 1 degree Celsius, the ice cube suddenly starts melting. That 1 degree shift from 0 degrees to 1 degree caused a huge change. And most people, when they're looking at the ice cube, they would say that that last change is the reason, that one last shift in temperature by just 1 degree, that is the reason why it caused the change. But in reality, it was because of all of the other previous changes. It was because of that change from minus 4 to minus 3 degrees, from minus 3 to minus 2, from minus 2 to minus 1, from minus 1 to 0. That is the reason that the ice cube melted when the shift changed from 0 to 1. Not because of that final change. The ice cube wouldn't have melted if it was just that 1 degree change. It was because of all of the previous changes. And following on from this, just how the results of Bob and Jim were determined by the actions and decisions they made before the event, you are a result of your previous actions. The point is, it's the tiny repeated decisions and habits that you make in your life that determine where you end up in life. It's not these huge, drastic, life-changing decisions that we hear all in the news, these overnight successes, these huge breakthroughs that people have. That is not the case. It's the small, repeated decisions that make the real difference. Just like how Bob and Jim, they ended up in completely different places in life. That wasn't a result of their interview. Where they ended up in life was a result of all of their previous decisions. And the same thing is applied to your life. Where you are right now, your body, your health, your mentality, your family, your friends, your fitness, everything that's going on in your life is a result of your previous actions. And that means that where you'll end up in life, whether you live a fulfilled life or a depressed life, that is a result of your future decisions and your future habits. And that is so empowering. That puts the power in your hands. You can decide where you'll end up if you start making the right decisions and the right habits. You see, it doesn't matter where you are in life at the moment. It really doesn't matter whether you're up here or whether you're down here. What matters is your trajectory. Your results are simply a lagging indicator of your trajectory. Now, some of you might be thinking, well, you're completely ignoring those things that are outside of your control. And you're completely right. There is always a small percentage chance that you could go out there and you could get hit by a car. And that's completely outside of your control. But do you think it's a more effective strategy to be constantly focusing on things that you don't control, or constantly be focusing on the positive and the things that you can control? Well, yes, you're completely right. It is a more effective strategy to almost put aside those things that you do not control for this case. By all means, you must recognize there are things you can and can't control if you're putting pressure and stress on yourself. But for this case, it's actually a more effective strategy to put aside those things that you can't control and start focusing on the benefits, focusing on the things that you can do. That is how you'll get to where you want to be. On top of this, there may be some of you thinking that I've tried to change my trajectory and my habits and make the right decisions. I've tried again and again and again, and I keep failing and failing and failing. Well, I used to be exactly like that. I can't count the amount of times that I'd say, right, today is the day. Today is the day I'm going to make huge changes in my life. I'd get all motivated. I'd make huge plans and all of these different habits that I'm going to make in my life. But I would fail again and again and again. And it's only when I realized one very simple thing that completely pulled me out of this, completely changed my life around. And once I realized that one thing, I could then look and recognize that I was making that same mistake again and again and again, but I just couldn't see it. And I'm willing to bet that the same thing is happening in your life. You're making the same mistake again and again and again, but you just can't quite see it yet. Well, in the next video in this free workshop, that is where I'm going to reveal to you that one secret. So in 2 days' time, the next video of this free workshop is going to be coming out. And that's going to reveal to you exactly how I changed my trajectory, drastically changed my trajectory very quickly. But not only did I do that, I did it with very little willpower and without very little effort at all. Now, that doesn't mean I'm saying there's no willpower involved. There is some, but most of us try to make changes in our lives that cause more willpower than any human has. But the changes that I'm about to show you in that next video can be done with enough, small enough willpower that every single healthy human will have. Now, I want to hear from you what your thoughts about this video are. So email me at andrew@andrewkirby.net, letting me know how much you want to make these huge differences. Because when you let that desire out of you, when you tell me how much you want to make these changes are, then these things are so much more likely to happen. So go ahead right now, email me at andrew@andrewkirby.net, telling me how much you want to change your trajectory in your life, and I will promise you I'll reply. The next video is going to be out in 2 days, and I'll see you then.